Menards is your electrical headquarters. We carry all the tools and testers you need for any electrical job. Stack up your toolbox with Southwire electrical products today. Right now, save big money on Southwire electrical tools, testers, cable ties, wire, and cable. Shop our huge selection in store at Menards. Ranked number one in customer satisfaction among home improvement retailers according to J.D. Power. For more information, visit jdpower.com/awards.
Save big money at Menards.
Kelly O'Neill, Joe Dredge,
hey.
Mornings on WROK. Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
7 minutes after six, News Talk 1440 WROK. It's Riley and Joe, brought to you by Wild Rose Casino and Resort in Clinton, Iowa. Thanks for waking up with us. We do appreciate that, especially you guys who are with us every single morning, up bright and early. We're glad you're here. Mostly cloudy, 19 is where we sit. 9 above is what it feels like as winds are coming at us at 9 miles an hour out of the north. Going to be a fairly decent day today, cold and cloudy, but that seems to be about it. Only about a 20% chance of us drawing any precipitation. Daytime high today, 27. Down to 19 tonight. Tomorrow on Friday, 34. Partly sunny, only a 2% chance of precipitation, but Friday night is cold. 7 above zero. Saturday, we only hit 26, all sun. Sunday, 53, mostly sun. And Monday, bumping up near 60 with partly cloudy skies.
Okay.
So, get through next, 72 hours of cold, and we should start to see a bit of a warm-up coming. Now, it's not going to be t-shirts and shorts yet, but it's going to be a lot better than it's been.
No, it's going to be fine.
Yeah.
It'll be fine.
You might... And, you know, you want to do t-shirts and shorts. Who are we?
Go for it.
You do what you want. What makes you happy?
Sun's out. You probably want to maybe open a sunroof while you're driving.
Sure.
Crack a window or two. Or open up a screen, something at the house. Let some fresh air in. It's spring cleaning time.
Yeah.
Let's clean things up.
You do you on that one. But those are the temperatures you'll be doing you with.
Yes,
so
you will.
That's what we have there. Last hour, we got busy talking about other things, and we did not get into our almanac.
A lot of bathroom talk.
That's true. Very important bathroom talk. We ought to blow that out of the way here and take a look at some things that happened on this date in history. Thursday, March the 10th, 69th day of the year. 296 remain.
Uh-huh.
Highlight in history on this date in 1876. Alexander Graham Bell's assistant, Thomas Watson, heard Bell say over his experimental telephone, "Mr. Watson, come here. I want to see you."
Yes.
From the next room of Bell's Boston laboratory.
Magic.
Yep, it was. And it kind of just sort of took off from there for Alexander Graham Bell and Thomas Watson.
A Tesla to Watson's Edison, you know what I mean? Was there somebody else trying to do the telephone invention?
I believe there were a couple of people working on it at the same time, but I think Alexander Graham Bell had a jump on it.
Okay, all right. I didn't know if there was somebody that got screwed out of a patent or had a better way of doing the telephone system and Graham just muscled his way through and
kind of like Edison.
Kind of Edison did.
If nothing else, I'll take your idea. And
tell it. Exactly. Yeah.
Edison or Graham Bell usually gets the credit. Few more names that might ring a bell. They say here. Let's see. Who is the other Italian engineer Antonio Meucci and German inventor Philip Rice independently invented telephone-like devices that achieved a key breakthrough of turning sound into electric signals almost a decade before Alexander Graham Bell.
Okay.
But at the same time, they just didn't get it out well enough. 2002, the House of Representatives accepted Meucci's work was so important that it could have been enough to prevent Alexander Graham Bell from getting a patent.
Oh.
Over the years, Bell's right to any credit has been challenged by evidence that he plagiarized key parts of his design, but that still remains under dispute.
Okay, so there is a little.
There's some argument about who did it first, but at this point, boy, it's, you know, the horse is gone.
It's gone.
You can do whatever you want with the barn door.
Sorry, Mr. Rice.
It's way gone. Yes. It was on this date in, 1496, Christopher Columbus concluded his second visit to the Western Hemisphere as he left Hispaniola for Spain.
Okay.
1785, Thomas Jefferson appointed America's minister to France, succeeding his pal Ben Franklin, who, from what we understand, really had a great time in Paris.
Really enjoyed his time.
Really enjoyed his time.
Yes, he did.
1864, Abraham Lincoln assigned Ulysses S. Grant, who had just received his commission as a lieutenant general, to the command of the armies of the United States.
Wow, that's a pretty big promotion.
That's quite a promotion.
Yes, it is.
1906, about 1,100 miners killed in northern France in a coal dust explosion.
Ugh.
1913, former slave, abolitionist, and underground railroad conductor Harriet Tubman died in Auburn, New York. No real word on her exact age, but it was believed she was well into her 90s.
Wow, that's amazing.
That is. 1965, Neil Simon's play, The Odd Couple, starring Walter Matthau and Art Carney, had its opening on Broadway.
I didn't know that Walter Matthau was the original.
Yeah, the original, him and Art Carney. And then when we decided we were going to bring that thing to TV, we went with Jack Klugman and Tony Randall, who most people remember in the roles of The Odd Couple.
Yeah.
A great, great series. Great theme song.
Yes.
It was on this date, 1985. Konstantin Chernenko, who was the Soviet Union's leader for about 13 months, died at the age of 73, took over by a guy named Mikhail Gorbachev.
That lasted for a while.
Yeah. Then we were in that period of Soviet leaders where somebody got the sniffles, disappeared from public. The next thing you knew, there was a funeral and somebody else was taking over. Chernenko got it for about 13 months before his head cold checked in.
Okay.
1988, pop singer Andy Gibb dead in Oxford, England at the age of 30. Heart inflammation brought on by excessive cocaine use.
Wow. Officially?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
He'd had some serious addiction problems at that particular time. Over to the birthday list. If today's your big day, it's become even bigger because of the first person on our birthday list. I saw a great meme the other day. It showed this guy saying, "Stop it." And underneath it, it had Putin going, okay. It's Chuck Norris.
Oh, Chuck Norris.
Chuck Norris is 82. Just a great meme. Chuck's got a phone looking angry saying, "Stop it." Putin going, "Okay." Wouldn't that be great?
The Chuck Norris jokes was a much more innocent time for us. Internet, I mean, it was better. It was better.
And the fact that Chuck himself had fun with
it. He liked it.
And one of those people I met as a kid.
Oh, you did?
Okay. I met as a kid, 5 minutes at most. But I remember him just being very, very imposing and
really
super nice.
Okay. He's not that tall, right?
No, he's not a huge guy, but he looked very imposing, especially to a 10, 12-year-old.
Did you know who he was?
Yeah.
Okay,
oh, yeah.
All right.
He wasn't as big a star, even close to what he is today.
Okay.
But he was fairly well known and was just breaking into movies.
What was Chuck Norris's breakthrough?
Well, let's see. There was a couple. I mean, he was a national champion a few times in karate.
Yeah.
I think it was, was it Enter the Dragon? It was one of the Bruce Lee movies. Yeah,
okay.
One of the Bruce Lee movies that he was in. But I remember him being very soft-spoken, very polite, very nice to everyone that he talked to. It seemed to enjoy spending time and talking to people, signed a few autographs. There weren't phones at that time, but held still while someone held up their disposable camera.
His first movie was Breaker
in
1977.
Good Guys Wear Black.
Uh-huh.
I thought that he had, well, maybe solo movie.
Well, but yeah, okay, yeah. But, starring role.
Starring role.
But, Breaker.
Yep, and then Walker, Texas Ranger, bunch of other different things.
Yeah, oh yeah, I forgot about Walker, Texas Ranger.
Oh yeah,
that was a amazing show.
And on for a very,
very
long
time. Yes.
So happy birthday, Chuck Norris, 82 today. Singer Dean Torrance of Jan and Dean fame is 82. You got actor Richard Gant at 78. Rock musician Tom Schultz of Boston is 75 today.
Okay.
TV personality and businesswoman from Shark Tank, Barbara Corcoran, is 73. Mm-hmm. Producer, director, writer, Paul Haggis hits 69 today. You got Shannon Tweed, who I believe still married to Gene Simmons. at 65 today.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sharon Stone is 64 today.
Yeah.
64. Yeah. Magician Lance Burton at 62. Actress Jasmine Guy is 60. Jeff Ament from Pearl Jam is 59. Britain's Prince Edward, he's the one who, you know, isn't in any trouble. He's 58 today. Rock singer Edie Brickell of Edie Brickell and the New Bohemians. One time, I believe, married to Paul Simon. Might still be. I don't know. 56 today.
Okay.
Paget Brewster is 53. Today.
I adore Paget Brewster.
I have always, too. Always a beautiful woman who can do comedy.
She's hilarious.
Wonderful at comedy.
Yeah, she's funny. She showed up in the last couple seasons of Community and Criminal Minds forever. And got her. I think everybody got to know her as Joey's girlfriend in Friends.
Yep. The one that we all hoped that he would hold on to.
Yes, yeah, hold on to it.
Hang on to that one. Like I said, a beautiful woman who could have done, you know, the seductress sort of roles and all that, but gravitated toward comedy.
And is aging wonderfully.
Yep. John Hamm, another guy who's aging pretty well, even though he's mad at Apple TV. He's 51 today.
Good commercial.
Rapper, producer Timbaland is 50 today. Robin Thicke is 45. Olympic gold medal gymnast Shannon Miller is also 45. Carrie Underwood is 39. Olivia Wilde is 38. Country singer Rachel Reinert is 33. And actress Emily Osment is 30. And there's your birthday list.
Good one right there.
Not too bad.
Good one. I've been a Paget Brewster fan for a long time.
Yeah, and for those who were thinking, I don't even know who that is.
Give it a little search. You know who that is. You know who that is.
Tell you what, it's so important. We'll take a break while you do that.
Yeah, I'll give you some time.
And come back with some sports and such. 617, News Talk 1440, WROK.
From him.
Over 95 years in the books and still on top. This is Rockford's News Talk 1440 WROK.
635 News Talk 1440 WROK. Riley and Joe, Thursday morning. It's clear now. We had a bunch of clouds before, but now they're starting to give way to clear skies. It's 19. It feels like it's 8. Daytime high today, not too big. 27 is where we're going. We'll drop to 19 tonight. We'll hit 34 on Friday. Friday night, 7 for an overnight low.
All right.
Saturday is a cold day, 26 degrees, but it should be all set. We don't go above 10 over the next 4 days.
All right.
So that's weather in a nutshell. Perfect. But next week promises to be warmer.
Like that.
We were talking about Major League Baseball in the sports segment there. Uh-huh. A little bit further into that one. Now we got 93 games now with the plug pulled on them. 93 additional games as of yesterday by Baseball Commissioner Rob Manfred, which pretty much, the way it's looking now, the idea that we'll play 162 full game schedule doesn't look promising.
Sounds bad. 140, I think, is the magic number of games they have to play before they have to start giving some money back to sponsors.
Oh, yeah. We want to avoid that if we can.
Uh-huh.
Yep. Now, so we also were threatening locked out players with loss of salary and service time, too. He did manage to work that one in.
Yeah.
Sides narrowed down. Apparently, many of the economic differences to a small margin got bogged down over management's attempt to gain an international amateur draft.
And I think part of the problem with this from the Players Association point of view is this was kind of a last minute ad.
Yeah, because I don't remember this being discussed at all previously.
It was, I think this is less of we disagree with what you're doing here and more of why are you trying to slide this into the last minute kind of thing.
Right.
Don't take an agreement that we have and then just put this on top.
Oh, by the way, I want this on there too.
Oh, yeah, we're going to do this too. No, we're not.
No,
we're going to. Damn it. Now we got to go negotiate.
Yep,
again,
now
guys.
We got to start all over again.
Yep.
At 6:30 p.m. yesterday, 98th day of the lockout, Rob Manfred announced two additional series had been canceled through April 13th. That raises the total to 184 games wiped out of the 2,430 regular season game schedule, or 7.6% of games.
Wow.
Manfred, quote, because of the logistical realities of the calendar, another two series are being removed from the schedule, meaning that opening day is postponed until April 14th. They go on to point out in the Associated Press story, given how close both sides were on economic issues, a breakdown over an international draft is puzzling and stunning. But following years of simmering distrust have heated to a boil. It's predictable. Arizona Diamondbacks president and CEO Derek Hall, quote, "There's a lot going on in the world right now where you can certainly look out of touch. I'm saddened by all this. Saddened by everything." Yeah, well, that looking out of touch thing is really front and center here. The gaps shrunk on the luxury tax, pre-arbitration bonus pool, and minimum salary. Management continued to press for its long-held goal of an international amateur draft. Players have repeatedly rejected the proposal since it was made on July 28th.
Right.
Max Scherzer tweeting out, quote, "We never offered the international draft. We did discuss it, but MLB told us they were not going to offer anything for it. At that point, we informed all players and agreed to no draft." The union reacted angrily to Rob Manfred's announcement that is pretty much the opposite of that.
Yes.
Quote, "The owner's decision to cancel additional games is completely unnecessary. After making a set of comprehensive proposals to the league earlier this afternoon and being told substantive responses were forthcoming, players have yet to hear back."
Yeah, I mean, at this point, it's almost it feels like the players' union is almost like a battered spouse. They're just expecting the baseball to take advantage of them.
Yep, it's going to go badly like, no matter like, what we do what, here.
Whatever you're saying, like everything that the owners offer is looked with a jaundiced eye. Like, what are you trying to pull over on us here?
What kind of scam is going on here? Rob Manfred, quote, "In a last-ditch effort to preserve a 162-game season this week, we have made good-faith proposals that address the specific concerns voiced by the MLBPA and would have allowed the players to return to the field immediately. The clubs went to extraordinary lengths to meet the substantial demands of the MLBPA. On the key economic issues that have posed stumbling blocks, the clubs proposed ways to bridge gaps to preserve a full schedule. Regrettably, after our second late-night bargaining session in a week, we remain without a deal."
Who's this statement from?
Rob Manfred.
Rob Manfred, okay. Yep.
He called off the first two series on March 1st, a day after his initial deadline for a deal. Last cancellations include four series finales on April 14th. Manfred did not use the word canceled. He left the appearance 162 games no longer could be played due to baseball's ninth work stoppage. So, yeah, that's where we sit. If they go through April 15th, that stoppage would spill onto the 75th anniversary of Jackie Robinson breaking the color barrier in the major leagues.
Don't want to do that.
Players have dropped their threshold for the luxury tax to $232 million this year, with increases to $235 in 2023, $240 in 2024, $245 in 2025, $250 in 2026.
Okay. All right.
Players had been at $238 million to $263 million in their previous proposal of a week earlier. They were within 2.5% of management's starting figure of $230 million in Tuesday's proposal.
Okay. All right. No, I mean, read the numbers. It's good to know. No one cares about the numbers.
No?
No one cares.
Really? They don't?
Just get, I mean, they're close enough. Do it. I don't know the answer to this.
I don't know either.
But no, I mean, it's a question I'm about to ask here. We do this every 5 years in baseball.
Yeah, is that how long they're for?
About,
5 years?
Yeah, about every 5 years. Mm-hmm. And there's always, you know, animosity and hating each other. Why don't we do this in other sports? What's wrong with baseball that they do this every 5 years? We get some news about labor negotiations in other sports.
Sure, there was danger of an NFL lockout at one time. There was talk about an NBA lockout, but that's all it was.
Just a little bit of talk.
They only went above the, hey, if this doesn't get straightened up, we could.
Hockey did a lockout a little bit ago.
Look how much that helped them.
Did not at all. This is not like hockey has a history of always.
Nope.
That was kind of a one-off for hockey. I don't know why every workforce, management and the workers, it's never going to be, you know, a kumbaya relationship. There's always one looking to get more from the other.
Oh, sure.
But it just seems to be so toxic in baseball. I mean, it just seems like there's legitimate hate going both ways, and
this has done nothing but throw gas on it.
Oh, absolutely.
It's not like, you know, now that we're working a little bit closer, maybe we were all a little hot-headed.
Yeah.
No. It's going the other way.
Are other sports organizations owned by people that have more interest in the good of the game that they own? Are NBA owners, do they want to grow the game more than Major League Baseball owners want to grow the game? And what's the disconnect? What's the difference between the makeup of an NBA owner and a baseball owner? I don't know.
I don't know either.
I don't know why baseball has this kind of specific problem every 5 years.
Yep. And knowing that it's coming and still doing nothing until it arrives. No preparatory work.
None.
No, hey, let's get out in front of this so we don't have this problem.
Yeah, I understand that, you know, not striking a deal, you know, a year and a half ago, things might change. But start talking. Start figuring out the problems.
Assuming you want to.
Well, yeah, assuming you... Well,
one side wants to.
There's a huge deal right there.
Yeah, assuming
Riles.
You want to. And I don't know the answer to who does and who doesn't.
I don't want to cast aspersions on all MLB owners about, you know, they don't care about the game. But it seems like at least, 24 of the 31 owners don't care about April baseball.
Enough who can exert control over how everything goes don't care about it.
Don't care about April baseball. Don't want it. It's a debt for them. They're not making, not turning too much of a profit in April. And
then maybe some of this meeting should be about eliminating April baseball. Maybe, you know, we short the season up and we start May 1st.
Hey, if that's going to stop this crap every 5 years and we cut baseball down to 140 games a year, as a fan, I'm fine with it. Players won't be happy with it because I'm sure that's going to start affecting some paychecks.
Sure.
And it goes down. I don't think players union will ever agree to going down to 140 game schedule. But I just don't know why baseball has this problem. And it stinks.
Where other leagues have it and have occasionally had work stoppages and all that, it does not happen with near the frequency that baseball. And the longest strike and most damaging one belongs to baseball.
Yeah, I mean, by a mile. You see the stat that was floating around yesterday about the average age of fans?
Oh, yeah. Is this the 37-57
thing?
Yeah,
average age of baseball fan is 57 years old. Average age of an NFL fan is 37 years old. And no young kids are getting into loving baseball.
Not nearly enough to sustain the sport.
Not nearly enough. I'm sure, you know, Pony League numbers are dwindling. I know travel ball is still a thing, but I don't know if it's as big as it was at one point.
Nope, and they continue to stick swords in the game here by doing this.
Yeah, I'm nowhere smart enough to know the solution to this. And as I've stated or shown last couple minutes, I'm not smart enough to figure out why. It's the problem.
We don't really know.
No,
but it continues to go on.
I just would like to watch baseball this year. Occasionally, it's going to be sad. It's going to be sad. I've talked about, you know, Matt Spiegel's one that. First had this phrase that I heard, but the summer companion, summer companion of baseball.
Right. Well, remember what we did there in the first year of the pandemic?
Watch Korean baseball.
Korean baseball was our summer companion.
Well, they're going to start kicking up here pretty soon, I think.
Now that we're familiar with teams.
The Doosan Bears.
647, News Talk 1440, WROK.
Menards is your electrical headquarters. We carry all the tools and testers you need for any electrical job. Stack up your toolbox with Southwire electrical products today. Right now, save big money on Southwire electrical tools, testers, cable ties, wire, and cable. Shop our huge selection in-store at Menards. Ranked number one in customer satisfaction among home improvement retailers according to J.D. Power. For more information, visit jdpower.com/awards.
Save